Alright, everyone. Sorry about that. Making sure it's recording. So, I'm going to teach you how to do navigation for your L4D2 map. Before I do that, I'm going to let you watch this quick little time lapse, I guess, of me making the map. It's not pretty, it's not supposed to be, it's just for educational purposes. Alright, now that you're done watching that, assuming that you did a better job at mapping than I did on that current one, you're gonna go ahead and get in game. You're gonna make sure you have access to your console via the options menu, and if you want to get the CFG for the controls that I'll be using, all that information will be in the link below. In the description below, and I'll also link you to the page that I constantly have open on my secondary screen whenever I'm doing navigation editing. So first, we're going to open up console, debug, we're going to type in zdebug1, and then navedit1, okay? And now that we have those open, my client already has the CFG running at all times, so if you downloaded it and you want to know how to start it, you do EXEC and then nav controls, assuming you didn't change the name. Okay, now what we're first going to do is do what they call
user left your channel.
What we're going to do is what they call nav mark walkable. So you can type that in console or use the page up slash the number 9 key on the numpad if you're using my CFG. So we're going to just get some general locations that are walkable, as in zombies should be able to walk on it, players, etc. So I only did a couple there. So now that I did that, I'm going to go into console, do nav underscore analyze, and then it's going to do its thing. And while we wait on that,
weapons over here,
we're going to see what just happened. I think I did it wrong. Hold on. I'm sorry, we want to do nav generate. So yeah, nav generate, my bad, and then nav analyze. Normally I'm not teaching it, so I don't usually fuck up like that. Alright, so now that the navigation is generated, you'll notice that in this navigation, there is a thing called escape route. And this is basically, you can look it up on the Valve developer page, but it's basically the route in which the director is going to think, slash, you made the players go in order to complete the map. And that'll be marked for all of the routes in order to get to the checkpoint. So, then there's door, escape route, just some extra navs, more escape route. So we're just going to run here with the bots, and we're going to run through and show you what the end looks like. There's that funky looking door. And then over here is the checkpoint slash escape route end. This is where the game would end once they reached here and closed the door. Now, obviously, you want some zombies. So, what we're going to do is tell director to turn off, so it's director stop, or director underscore stop, and NB delete all will get rid of the bots. Then we're going to go into noclip. And you'll notice there's some navigation up here, maybe not on this building, but there's some navigation on some of these buildings, which is good. That's what we wanted. So let's mark some areas that the zombies can come from. We're going to go over here. We're going to go to the corner. Okay. We're going to select them by either hovering over them or using the select option on the CFG that I gave you. And then we're going to type in nav, mark, I'm sorry, we're going to do mark obscured. And basically what obscured means is the players can't see it, and it's a place that zombies, you know, a mass amount of zombies should be able to spawn from. I'm going to do it a couple more places. And then the most important, right here, because this is where I kind of want them to come from the most. And then we're going to make sure there's no issues. So nav Alright. So, now that that's taken care of, we're going to do a nav analyze. Oops. Nav analyze. And that's going to do its thing again. Okay. Hopefully, once we start the director again, okay, so see those little dots out there? Those are zombies. So, zombies are already in effect. Not very many, though. There they are. Zombies. Delicious. There's a zombie. Not anymore. So no zombies are coming from up there, because, I don't know, the director just doesn't want to. Just fine. Obviously, this is a very simplistic map, and since Left 4 Dead is a semi-random game, you're going to want a much larger map and much more options for the director to spawn things from. And now it seems that the director is a little angry that we're wasting time. He's gonna start throwing some special effects at us. So yeah, that's basically how you navigate your map, or do basic navigation. If you'd like specific tutorials on specific parts of navigation, let me know. But that's the basics, and that's basically what you'll need to get your maps going and working. Alright, thanks for watching. Hope this helped you out. Have a great day.